how to ask the right questions. I am such a firm believer in asking questions. I love asking questions because I think when you ask questions, you get so much of clarity over what could be your next step. And when people ask me, what are your top questions? Here are the three top questions that have helped me a lot. Number one, whenever I'm in a position where things are not going my way, I feel like there is a roadblock. I feel like people are not behaving the way that I expected them to, or my results are not happening the way that I expected them to. I'm working hard, I'm doing everything right, at least what I think, but they're not yielding the right results. I don't fall in the trap of asking the question, why is this happening to me? Why, God, why? Why am I the only one being singled out? Why is no one listening to me? Why is the world behaving this way? Instead, I ask this question, what is this telling? What is this telling? And I love this question because this question basically wants to hunt for the truth. It wants to know, what is it that I should know that I may be closing my eyes to? If someone is not behaving the way that I expected them to, I don't ask, why is that person not behaving this way? Instead, I ask, what is this telling me? What is it that I am turning a blind eye to? What is it that I'm choosing to ignore? What is it that I perhaps do not know that this person knows? What is this telling me? That's a powerful question. The other question which I love is something that I ask often, which is, what am I optimizing for? I'm a firm believer in this concept of one task, one goal. Everything that I do needs to have one goal. If anything that I do has more than one goal, it just means I don't have any goal. If through the one marketing campaign that I want to run, I also want to get new customers and reactivate old customers and also want to have our vendors speaking highly of us and also want to have our employers feeling great about the brand that they work for, it's not good. What is the one thing that I do? If in my job I want money and I want learning and I want a great boss and I want great work-life balance and I want a vacation or a great offsite and I want great amenities and perks, that just means that you don't know what you want. What is the one thing you're optimizing for? The one thing you're optimizing for. When you focus on that one thing that you want, you suddenly become clearer on how you should. Because if you want the best money from your job, that may mean something very different from if you want the best work-life balance from your job. If you want the most learning from your job, that could mean very different things than if you want the company or the job with the most perks. And it also tells you what is it that you value? What is it that drives you? What is it that motivates you? And that's why this is a great question. What are you optimizing for? And the third one is, whenever you have an idea that you feel so excited about. It could be an idea for a new startup. It could be an idea for something you should do at your job. It could be an idea that you have for someone else, maybe advice for a friend, whatever the case may be. The question that I always ask is, if this idea is really so good, how come it hasn't happened already? If this idea is really so good, how come it hasn't happened already? Because the truth is, I'm not the smartest person I know. You're not the smartest person that you know. Which means that whatever is the idea that you have, thousands of people have had the same idea. So how is it that you don't see it in action? If you're working in a company and you're like, hey boss, I have a great idea. Before you start to share that, ask yourself, how come it hasn't happened already? Like, is there something that you don't know? Is it that this idea is very common? You're not the first person to think about it. And there's a reason why it hasn't happened. Ask yourself that question. Investigate. Find the truth. Find out what is it that people who had the idea earlier than you know more than what you do. What is it that they know that you do not? And that's why this question is such a terrific question. How come it hasn't happened already? And when you combine these three questions, you get such a powerful way of approaching life because it just simplifies things and makes it very clear that all that you're looking for is just the truth. You're looking not to find a reason to explain yourself. You're not looking for an excuse. You're not looking to blame someone else for where you are. All that you're doing is accepting responsibility for where you are and then asking yourself this question. What is this telling? What am I optimizing for? And how come it hasn't happened already? And when you find these three then you genuinely find all other answers that you look for.
Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that whenever we put up a new video, you're aware of it.